V1.
This Airbus A330 leaves the runway. But this isn't a real airport, and I'm not in a real plane. It's a simulator, the sort that's used to train today's pilots. It's an exact replica of the cockpit, right down to the noises it makes. At the heart of the Airbus cockpit philosophy is the side stick. When it was introduced, it was a radical departure from conventional flying. Now the pilot uses it to control the pitch and the roll of the aircraft. It uses technology called fly-by-wire. Fly-by-wire sends signals to computers, which then command the movements. Today, both Boeing and Airbus planes have fly-by-wire technology. Airbus's chief operational advisor, Harry Nelson, has been flying for 50 years.
Fly-by-wire is here to stay, and I can confidently say to you that fly-by-wire with envelope protection has reduced the accident statistics by 50%. 50%. So I'm talking now, we're achieving an accident rate of one accident per 10 million flight hours.
On an Airbus, the side sticks, operated by the captain on the left and the first officer on the right, work independently of each other. One pilot cannot feel the side stick movements made by the other. This asynchronicity is one reason why the pilots on AF-447 didn't realize each pilot was commanding the plane to do different things. Airbus planes also have envelope protection, which in normal conditions prevents the plane from being flown dangerously. When there's a serious fault, the protections are designed to go away, and the pilots receive detailed information from the computers. There is a logic to the way the Airbus plane tells the pilot that something's gone wrong. It starts with a warning sound, which has to be acknowledged. That draws attention to the ECAM messages, which then come up in order of priority. On the Qantas A380, where the engine exploded after leaving Singapore, the ECAM computer generated more than 50 messages that took the crew almost an hour to clear before the plane landed safely. So the question becomes, are pilots overwhelmed? The increasing demand for pilots today mean planes are designed for a trained flight crew at all levels of experience. Now the human factor is being looked at more closely. Why pilots behave in certain ways in a crisis, which seems to contradict everything they've been taught.
Stall, 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 stall.
There are industry trends which need to be looked at. We have an even, perhaps a younger set of pilots coming into the industry, perhaps even with less experience, less military pilots coming into the industry.
Is the cockpit too complicated?
We designed for the whole range, if you like, to cover those pilots who perhaps were at the lower end of the scale who may need that kind of protection. The better pilots never need it.
Closing the training gap between the different level of pilots is paramount. While flying is, without doubt, the safest form of travel, the industry is considering the lessons to be learned. Airlines, manufacturers, regulators, and pilots. Everybody is looking to see what needs to change to improve the way we fly.